Here are some local corporate headlines. San Miguel Corporation clarifies the new Manila International Airport is not being built on reclaimed land. The statement comes amid the suspension of all Manila Bay reclamation projects. Located in Bulacan, the NMIA is said to be the country's largest international gateway with four runways. SMC shares closed 0.8% higher in Friday trade. On to first half earnings, Globe Telecom saw its net income drop 27% in the first half due to the absence of a one-time gain from the partial sale of Globe's data center last year. Its core net income also declined 10% to nearly 10 billion as OPEX expansion outpaced revenue growth. Globe shares ended trade 0.5% higher. Meanwhile, Shell Philippines rebounds from its first quarter net loss, bringing in over 120 million pesos in net income during the first half. Its total marketing volume increased 9%, while its non-fuel retail posted 14% growth from last year. However, it notes declining oil prices and rising interest rates outweighed its growth. The company shares climbed over 1%. The parent company of Philippine Airlines sees its first half net income surge to 13.6 billion pesos. It cites an 89% surge in passenger volume and its load factor improving to 82%. However, it also notes higher costs due to rising fuel prices and an increase in operated flights. PAL Holdings shares slipped nearly 0.2%. And finally, Emperador's revenue in the first half climbed 11% to 31 billion pesos on the back of a global whiskey segment growth. The company says Emperador's growing whiskey portfolio brought double-digit growth in Asia and the U.S. Emperador shares closed flat. Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Occidental Petroleum. The U.S. Department of Energy awarded a $1.2 billion project to Occidental and Climeworks Corporation to remove over 2 million tons of carbon emissions. Shares of Occidental are down by 0.5% in pre-market trade. Also in focus, shares of Virgin Galactic, which successfully brought three tourists to the edge of space and its second commercial mission. The news sent the stock up over 3% in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on UBS after the Swiss bank said it has ended a loss protection agreement and a public liquidity backstop put in place by the Swiss government when it took over rival Credit Suisse. Shares of UBS are trading in the green at 20.25 Swiss francs apiece.
Let's check on European markets first. They're down on the last trading day of the week, with most sectors seeing losses. London's FTSE 100 down by more than 1%, even as data showed the British economy eked out a surprise growth of 0.2% in the second quarter, thanks to solid household consumption. As for Wall Street, futures are flat ahead of the July producer price index data that will give more clues on how the Federal Reserve will move in September. Meanwhile, global oil prices are climbing, underpinned by tightening global supply. This is after the International Energy Agency said OPEC Plus supply cuts could erode oil inventories in the rest of the year, potentially driving prices even higher. It notes, though, economic headwinds will limit global demand growth in 2024.